gazebo?
The gazebo, yeah. You have a lot of time. So they already turned out the lights now, do you need,
Nope, I'm fine.
They're doing you like they do me.
I know.
They're not gonna let you sit down. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I wanna take this time and invite all of you to bottom my friends, the residents of our building, hello.
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 We're getting the hello back there. I want you, we did put one of our flashlights on the mortician scene. She's already coming on and off. Magdalene, if that's you, can I get you to turn it all the way off? All the way off if that's Magdalene.
It's on.
So is this my lady in red back there? If it's my lady in red, bright, take it all the way to bright for me. We have somebody in the mirror.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think that it's, can you tell me who it is back there? Denied? Well, I'm sitting down. I don't really want to get up. Is that okay, guys? Denied? I don't know what that means. So would you guys like to tell them hello?
Hello.
See how they denied me on who's back there.
just to let everybody know, the word eerie has come up on the...
Eerie.
Mm-hmm. Eerie.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that doesn't necessarily mean like eerie, eerie. Because we, you know, it could even be Lake Erie.
Disturb.
So what are you guys upset about back there? Huh? So are you guys having fun? Is that what you're telling me? So who are you wanting to get up? The psychic. Hello, is Doc Holliday in here? I don't know if you guys got that. That was real clear, Holliday. So Doc Holliday, if you're in here, could you come up and maybe tap for me? We have somebody behind the lady that I was talking with before we started.
What is the light that keeps going on there?
That's our flashlight in the back.
Oh, that, okay.
Oh, yeah, that's,
yeah, that's the one I keep asking who's back there, and they told me deny. We have several that are around that. So I have a question. Is one of my morticians in here tonight?
Where's that light?
That's our flashlight on the table.
Oh.
It's actually rolled some.
Yeah, it...
We have somebody in that back door. You guys can take pictures. I just ask that you warn the group, because now that we are in the dark, it can be really rough on our eyes.
We can do it with flash, right?
Yeah, with flash. Just warn everybody. I would take two at a time, just because of the main fact you want one to compare by.
Yeah.
So does anyone here have any questions?
I'm going to take a picture too.
For some reason, I can't. It's pretty bright
pictures
back.
Creep me out.
That light's pretty bright back there, but I can't. It's not showing up on mine.
Yeah.
I'm going to take
it. It probably has a lot to do with where you're sitting. You may not truly be seeing it. You got to remember, a phone is not like a camera that has night vision in it.
Yeah.
Or even being able to address... A night-type vision.
Yeah. I'm just thinking that light's pretty bright, so, because it's picking up on a lot of lights that are, like, it's picking up on that one back there.
Yeah.
So I was just thinking, I'm wondering, because that light was pretty bright and it wasn't picking it up, so.
So can you tell me how many of the residents in this building would like to come up here and talk to us? Could you give me some numbers, please? Numbers, guys. I thought when I first turned it on, I heard 6.
25.
25.
So for the one, the gentleman that just told me you just got, what did you just get? question by the just got, because we do have a part of the Wells Fargo with us. We do know that we have a couple of our thieves that were bank robbers in here. So I have a question. Are my bank robbers in here the ones that are always wanting to get to Wells Fargo? If so, I'm not going to actually use the SCD-1. I would like for you to use a different piece of equipment. I actually have the periscope on the table. I have one up on the bar. I have a flashlight on the table, and I have the flashlight in the back that just got turned off. Could you use one of those if you could tell me if you're here? Could you turn one of them on? Are any of you guys seeing the sparkles that are happening back there?
No.
That's too dark for me to see.
No, it's like around the bar area. Oh. Once in a while I'm seeing like little sparkles. When I see those, typically anyone can see them. Yeah. I've even seen where the periscope is, every once in a while it's brighter, and then it's dimming down. That's the kind of stuff you're going to be looking for back there. It could even take that and totally close it off. For the one that's at the back, can I get you to turn it off for a second, please? All the way off for me, not on, but off. I would like to ask a question. You still have it on, though, not off. Are you guys watching that shadow in there?
No.
On that flat, can you see the shadow on that wall? And almost see a spirit up in that one. All the way off. You almost got it. All the way. Just a little bit more.
You had it
almost all the way off.
You can do it.
The meter just said liquid head.
Liquid head?
Material.
We have minus, and we may have a minor.
Disc.
Second disc.
So for the one at the back, if you are a lady, could you turn it on for me? Only if you're a lady in that very far back. So I have a lady up front with us. So do I have a gentleman in the back? If I have a gentleman in that back, you can turn that flashlight on as well. Even though I think I know who it is. I think it's Oscar back there.
Yeah.
And for all of you, Oscar is special needs.
Oh.
So,
poor Oscar.
A lot of times we'll hear devil, those kind of words.
Mm-hmm.
At that time frame, that's what they called special needs.
Oh.
He never really showed up till I came over here and was playing with my grandson, and he came forward that day. So,
is anybody named Dan?
Yes, we do have a name.
The name Dan just came up on the... meter.
So, Dan, are you the one at the back? He's inside where we're at inside. Could you say that again? We're at inside is Dan. So where is he standing up at? Could you give me a position? He's leaned up somewhere.
By the bar, maybe?
So Dan, are you up at the bar? I'm trying to
see. You said yes.
Yes. So I have a question, Dan. Are you wearing a cowboy hat? You must be over to the left because I'm not seeing you. If you are, do you think maybe you could move over where I could see you? Maybe over closer to that mirror where we could hear you. Well, the one at the anomaly meter, could you please back off of it, please? Thank you. All the way away, please. We have some children up here as well. Is that teddy bear still running? I don't know. Thank you. I hadn't heard it, so.
No.
Are you okay?
Both hands are red.
Yeah.
What hands are red?
Yeah, the teddy bear.
Oh,
the
teddy bear.
Could you back up away from that a minute, please? All the way from away from the teddy bear. Thank you.
Oh, yeah, thank you.
Oh, no. Well, I can't ask a question if you're right up on it.
You gotta go stand somewhere else, buddy.
Do I have a couple of kids up around that teddy bear? Can you show me where you're at? Can you light both of the paws or one of the paws where you're at? We do have kids in here as well, don't we?
Oh, yeah. On the right hand.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh,
jeez. Do you like sitting up in her lap? If you do, can you get away from the paw? Do you realize that she's a mama too? You can trigger whatever you want on the teddy bear. She's like, yeah, I'm not going to. We had a tap above us. So do I have somebody that would like to be brave enough to go to that bar?
Not anymore.
I'm quite comfortable.
What'd you say, Kimba?
I said I'm quite comfortable sitting here.
I'll do it.
All right. I'm going to get you to sit while I'm doing this.
Oh, that's nice.
Yes. We'll take that flashlight out of there and bring it maybe up to the
I don't know what I'm saying.
Case.
Just teddy bear.
That way they're not messing with this as we get it started.
Woo! It's a disco. It's a disco. Well, it was a disco.
Uh-oh, it says sacrifice.
Sacrifice.
Yeah. Did I sacrifice somebody to the back? Is that what you're saying? Yes, we're going to put somebody right up here. Huh? Yeah, this is where we get to have fun.
Oh my God.
We're going to sacrifice one of you guys so I can talk to them.
Not me. I'm just reading the words.
Yeah. I'm the camera guy. So I want you guys to see what that does. It does make a total pattern. That is a laser. But I want you to notice where you see lights and where you do not see lights. All those lights should go right through those bottles. We already had one that said he was up at the bar. If you will look to the left of that mirror, probably about a foot and a half, we have a section that's a little bit shorter than me. That is already blocked out. I am actually very tall for a man at that age, at that group. They were about 5 foot to 5 foot four. Can you see the dark spot?
Yes.
Okay. I can see the dark spot.
So now I'm gonna kinda show all of you when they come through it, they can run through it that fast. I don't know if you're seeing, it's really changing hard and fast if they really run through it. So you're really going to have to use your entire vision. But they could also come through it just like that to maybe just one or two lights on you. So Mel, do you have the flashlight so
yes.
We can get the wind up? You want to get her up there?
The mirror just said noise, branches, guy.
Yeah, my back is like ice.
What, so?
I already have one on my back. Yeah, we already have one up there. Do you see the periscope light?
Mm-hmm.
So you want to stand up there with her, Mel?
I'm the sacrifice.
Yeah, you're the sacrifice. They said that the minute I sent you into the back.
Now it says funeral.
Okay. Yeah, we are at a funeral home, huh, guys? And the lady to the right, what's your name, sweetie?
Carolyn.
Carolyn. So ladies and gentlemen, I want you to notice I have Carolyn and Mel up there. All of you guys should be very, very comfortable around Mel at this point. So you're more than welcome to go up there and interact. Edith, if you're in here, I want you to notice neither one of those girls have their hair done proper. For all of you guys up there, you're going to like that because it's all down and we're showing how pretty it is. So you guys want to say hello to them. Now, I want you guys over there to look at Carolyn's hair. Can you see what's happening over to the right side? And to the left side, it is flickering.
Yeah, the left side's flickering.
So can I get you guys to maybe run your hands through her hair some more? Let her feel that. You guys have lifted my hair, so you could kind of push it back. We also had some movement on her lower leg. I want you to notice Mel's side on the left, her left arm, we have hardly no lights on it, and the top three that are up there by her shoulder are flickering a little. And this does record in the dark very well, by the way.
Puddle, oxygen, puddle.
Brave. So do I have some brave girls up there? Is that what you're saying? Oh, okay. Are you going to go up there and get some shots with them? I want you to notice Mel's arm on the right side. You see how it's glowing a little bit? It shouldn't be doing that. Okay, Mel, are you hearing walking up there? Because I could have sworn I heard some come across this floor.
I thought it was somebody next door, but yeah, it sounded like it right
there. It's like right here by us.
Yeah. Heard the floor creak.
Ooh.
And that was actually Mel shifting a little bit.
Yes, yeah, sorry.
Disease ran.
So who do we have that had one of the diseases in our town? Could you get, tell me what your name is and what you have? You're cold?
Arms.
It said what?
Arms.
Okay, now I want you to look at Caroline's left arm. Watch his shoulder. Or down by her elbow. We were getting movement on one of them. Now, gentlemen, you're more than welcome to go over there and hang out with them. See what's going on. And also, there was one right there on her, it's right at the inside of her elbow. That one light that you're seeing, it's been going in and out. I just want you to remember they are our ladies. And we have butt grabbers in here. So are you feeling anything, Caroline, on your hair? Mm-mm. No. She just actually shook her head.
I'm sorry.
You're not feeling any tingling?
Not on my hair.
You feeling cold anywhere?
I'm actually, like, my lungs.
Your lungs?
Mm-hmm.
So I have a question. Nina Cochise, are you in here right now? Yes, thank you, Nina Cochise. He was actually Cochise's great-grandson. He was also a medicine man, and he is buried on the Allen Street Cemetery. And he was a medicine man. He was a healer. So he may be up around you. So more than welcome, you guys, to go over there. Maybe vibrate that, maybe walk a little bit. Carolyn, are you feeling anything on your left leg anywhere?
No.
You guys see what's happening around her knee, just above her boots? We have some on this side. You can see very well where it's blacked out. We've actually lost that pattern. And you see lights that are kind of shimmering on her. So, all right, guys, if you want to go over there and tug on our kids, we may have some coins in those pockets up there. Okay.
What was
that? That was on the other side of our building. You see what's happening to her right now?
Garden, dark.
Is it dark back there? Are you guys saying it's dark? We're getting movement on Mel's right elbow as well. I'm getting walking up behind us.
Hmm.
You're more than welcome to, you don't have to stay at that bench, you can come up here.
Can we take a picture?
Yeah. Well, okay. They have videos real well.
I don't know if someone's tapping their foot. I can hear something.
So would somebody else like to take a chance up there?
Hmm.
None of our guys are going to be brave?
Oh, yeah.
You want to switch? You want to switch, Mel, to the line? We're going to get two of our guys up there. Yeah, get kind of between them, if you don't mind, Caroline. I wanna see what, yeah, they definitely said yes because the light went on.
Standing by whatever that yellow light is. I can't remember what it was.
I would appreciate if you go ahead and turn that flashlight off.
You blow it up and just slide with your fingers. Flashlight. The one in the back completely stopped. How could they? That one looks to have changed position.
So the gentleman that's to the right, can you give me your name? That was me. It's what?
Bill.
Bill? The one to the left.
Chuck.
Now when you guys are up there, it really helps if you guys are very still, but all of you talk to them. And it doesn't really matter what you talk about, just be still and talk to them.
Informed Bishop allow.
Leaven?
Leaven.
Leaven. Leaven, allow, and Bishop. Something tickles over here.
Yeah. Calvin, you're going to have to be real still because we're getting movement in your hat and I need to verify that it's not your head. Or Chuck. Where am I getting Calvin? So do I have a Calvin in here by that coming across my mouth? You're right here? Where are you at? So I have a question, Tom. If you're here and Dan, if you're here, you're more than welcome to go over there. The guys can pour you a shot. All you gotta do is ask them for a shot. They have all kinds of alcohol up there. Hank, if you were up there.
A Mike.
And Mike, if you're in there, maybe you guys could wiggle that bar a little bit for me. Let them know that you would like a shot. And they are in between, on either side of that lady, but you guys are more than welcome to still go up and interact with her. Chuck, are you feeling cold in any spot, warmer in other spots?
No.
You wanna, I'm gonna turn that flashlight up. They're pointing at him. You're not feeling colder or pressure or anything around your left side?
I think that shadow.
Are you guys seeing how he's totally dark right there?
Yes.
Yeah. Look at the bottom of Carolyn's boots.
Yeah, they're gone. And that makes a pattern. So wherever it's broke like that, we do have spirit up around them. And Bill, are you feeling anything odd around your head?
That's what I was looking at.
No.
It doesn't tickle. Do you guys know what it feels like? No, what it feels like if spirit's up around you. You're going to make it where it's hard to breathe. You'll feel heaviness on your body somewhere. It can tickle. It'd be like just one little spot that makes you want to tickle. It can make you feel like you're going through cobwebs. You can have certain parts of your body colder than other parts of your body. Say like from your knees down could be cold, and from your knees up you're just the normal temperature. Yeah. So, Dan, I have a question. Is that you? Are you the one that goes over there and plays peekaboo?
Yeah.
Is it Sid?
Wes? It's Sid? So, I have a question, Sid. Are you the gentleman that I've caught with the tan cowboy hat on and the big beard that wears his six shooter kind of low? You guys saw that?
I saw that shadow.
Yeah. We also had an orb that come through. Look at that.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa.
See that?
That's cool.
And that's... You guys could try to get it. You think maybe you could tip it a little bit for me?
What time? It's 9:30.
Not much? I bet you that he'd be kind of surprised if you could make that hat tilt a little bit. Just keep coming in on that brim. Keep coming up closer to it.
Up high light. That's my shoe. Oh, I'm just looking at something that's underneath me.
So does anybody else want to try that?
I'm talking to the light.
Because we're actually at 17 after 9.
I'll try it.
Would it be okay if we went?
Yeah. So, Mel, you want to help them get down? And let's put a chair up there for her.
Oh, did you see that?
Oh, yeah, that's done.
They're saying Mary is done. Do you want me to hold the thing?
She has it.
And we had the periscope at the table go off too as they were walking by. Surface yours to see. Maybe you want to switch it where she. Okay, I see what you're doing. I wasn't sure. And what's the lady's name?
Denise.
And the gentleman's name?
Ken.
Now, when you're up there, be as still as with you because some of my guests are a little bit shy. They're not used to talking to you like me and Mel are. I want you guys to know that Nanette and her husband are going to be coming up here in the next couple of weeks. I don't know if you heard that crack that on to the right. We're going to actually try to cook breakfast in here. If you guys are wanting some bacon and eggs or some ham and sausage, I'm going to have to know what we need to bring this time around. For any of my guys that are here, do you think maybe one of you could come over here and maybe touch the bar for me?
Little nod.
So I don't know if any of you guys are watching me. I'm actually going to tell you what I am feeling. If you look about mid back down to the top of my rear end, it is cold. You should be seeing lights going in that area. So Hank, you think maybe you could come over here and interact with us? You can come right between me and the bar, and you can come right.
Storm and cold.
Yeah, it is cold up here.
Yeah.
And I know that we got a storm coming in. You guys are going to be okay in here.
It's safe. What a... Does the person who's right there not like the camera? Because every time I take it off of you, you seem to go nuts. I'm gonna take it you don't like being filmed because every time I try to take a picture of you, you.
They're playing, that's
stop.
Why.
Ah.
Probably a little kid.
In my case, I'm just gonna take a picture of you.
Video with or without.
Yeah.
With or without flash.
Mm-hmm. Ah, you like your picture.
If you got flash on the video, use the flash. Otherwise, it'll come out too dark.
I have no clue how to use flash on video.
You guys
use flash on video. Oh, perfect.
So, Inga, are you in here? I'm going to look in the
bathroom.
You can see an outline of a cowboy hat. You're not wearing a cowboy hat.
No, I'm not.
So, Inga, if you're in here, you think maybe you could sing her one of your songs. Can you sing it to her in soprano? She was actually an opera singer here.
I can tell you like being filmed.
So, you guys should be singing something in this area.
Can you make it warm in here?
Nora, did you just move your right arm?
Yes, I was showing how I was really feeling some movement. My shirt is actually moving.
This wall is in
there. Yeah, no, your right shoulder's not.
This wall is in the way. You can't see through the wall. see the little fairy dust sparkles?
Yeah, I do. Those were the sparkles I was telling you to look for when we were looking out. Some of the things we see, other people might not see, just because we see them. We hear the tapping on the other side of the wall.
Nora, you
stepped
on my head?
Yeah.
Because
your hair is dark.
Dark. Yeah, it's been dark for a while.
Yeah.
See that?
Over on her her right, like the right side of her head, where her neck meets her shoulder area.
Mm-hmm.
Those lights were all moving.
The person in the back appears to have stopped completely.
So the one that's moving my shirt at the back. Do you think you could do me a favor and really move that shirt for me?
I'm hearing noises. I don't know if that's coming from. Yeah, because where we're from, I'm so used to wind sounds just banging up against the side of buildings. It's really windy. From where we're from.
Yeah, that's right. It's right.
You know, like no, I know, but when it gets really windy at night, you can hear like the shut. You can hear like the trees hitting. You know what I'm talking about. What?
Your right side.
A good chunk of it.
So the
your right side is black. And so is your back, your lower right part of your
head. And now it's going down the back side of your left shoulder. The darkness.
Yep. It's almost like somebody's got their arm around you at the top.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Messing with Denise's hair a couple of times.
The bar just moved. Whoever it is actually.
It says a go, some, and cheat.
A large portion of lights that are registering. If I pick it up, it's not.
Like it's on your right cheek, kind of toward your bottom of your leg, starting at the top of your leg.
Right, yeah, I have two. I have pink moving, and I believe the pink is leaking right now. Yeah, it's moving right
now. That wind.
Something like this. I'm kind of the flu because I'm feeling like I could puke.
Don't do that.
So ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank all of you that came in and interacted. Hank, I want to thank you for coming over and standing next to me and letting people see you come over and give me a hug. That was pretty awesome. The thief, I'm pretty positive you were the one in front of me. I hope that one day you give me your name instead of just the thief. I'm going to let the SCD one run, so if there's something that either one of you want to tell me, this is going to be your time. For those of you that can see the left side of that mirror, it is totally black over there now. Tell who to stay. Ken, you're really getting movement on you. Now with this, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be the last time I'm in here tonight, Mel and I. I want to thank all of you for what you've done. You two want to shut your eyes?
No, I heard something. I didn't know you were there.
No. Yeah. I'm not moving, but okay. So if you guys will shut your eyes, Mel, turn those lights on. Those are stage lights, so they are really, really bright.